this episode of Walking Around with Herb, we're in Berlin, Germany.
We took the train from Warna Mundi through northern Germany, passing through small towns and villages along the way. The one-way trip to Berlin took about 3 hours. These yellow fields are mustard plains. Berlin is the capital and largest city in Germany, both in area and population. The city straddles the banks of the River Spree. About one-third of the city's area is composed of forest, parks, gardens, rivers, canals, and lakes. Berlin is said to be over 8 times larger than Paris. Currywurst was invented by Herta Haver in Berlin in 1949. I completely missed what our guide said this structure was about. I think it was something about currywurst. If you know, please tell me in the comments. In the 1920s, Berlin was the third largest municipality in the world. After World War II and its subsequent occupation, the city was divided and eventually separated by the Berlin Wall in 1961, preventing immigration from east to west. When you explore the city and want to know if you're in the east or west side, look for the tram tracks. If you see them, you're in East Berlin. They were abolished in the west after reunification. One of the best-known landmarks in Germany, the Brandenburg Gate, was built in the 18th century on the orders of Frederick William II during the Batavian Revolution. When the Nazis ascended to power, they used the gate as a party symbol. After Germany's surrender at the end of the war, the gate was located in the Soviet occupation zone and became a monument to the border between East and West Germany. After the Berlin Wall was demolished during the revolutions of 1989, the Brandenburg Gate border crossing was officially reopened when Helmut Kohl, Chancellor of West Germany at the time, walked through on December 22, 1989. This is the site of one of the Nazi book-burning ceremonies held on May 10, 1933. A memorial marks the location in the center of the square. Berlin has more canals than Amsterdam or Venice. Checkpoint Charlie was a crossing in the Berlin Wall, designated as the single crossing point for foreigners and members of the Allied forces. It was one of the best-known symbols of the Cold War, representing the separation of East and West. These days, Checkpoint Charlie has become one of Berlin's primary tourist attractions, complete with actors for photo ops. Here's a marker near Checkpoint Charlie, where the Berlin Wall once stood. This business rents Trabants, which are cars that were produced in East Germany during the Cold War. East Germans were placed on a waiting list to buy one, which could take as long as 10 years in some cases. The dark glass building on the right is the headquarters for Deutsche Bank. Construction of the Berlin Wall began on August 13, 1961. The wall was a guarded concrete barrier that divided Berlin from 1961 to 1989. This section of the Berlin Wall is next to the Martin Grovius Bau Exhibition Hall. It's estimated that 2.7 million people left the German Democratic Republic and East Berlin between 1949 and 1961. The wall was erected to stop further immigration from east to west. On November 9, 1989, the fall of the Berlin Wall was a pivotal event in world history, marking the fall of communism in Eastern and Central Europe. An end to the Cold War was declared at the Malta summit 3 weeks later, and the reunification of Germany took place in October the following year. Berlin is home to the world-famous Berlin Opera and Berlin Philharmonic Orchestra. The Hotel Adlon in Berlin is where Michael Jackson introduced his son Blanket to the world by dangling him over a balcony. the Kaiser Wilhelm Memorial Church was badly damaged in a bombing raid in 1943. After the war, the church was rebuilt, keeping the war-torn tower as is, because it had become thought of as the heart of Berlin. You can still see war damage today. We're in another part of Berlin, and here are more remains of the Berlin Wall.
And that's all for this episode of Walking Around with Herb from Berlin, Germany.